Well, hello YouTube. It's Dylan here, how you going? I just wanted to do an update. Today is 23rd of April. I had my fourth psych appointment today. I've been having them every 2 weeks. And I got my referral today for my endo. So I have my endo appointment on the 8th of May, so just over a week, and I'm trying not to be too excited. I'm just going to that appointment with the basis of that they're just going to do some blood work. If they happen to give me tea on that day, fantastic. If not, it should only be another week or so after that. So the finish line is getting closer and closer, which is really good. Things with me. So I just got back from Melbourne. I went on a bit of a holiday, cleared my head, come back feeling really good. So that was my dog making gross noises. I was feeling really messed up before I left. It's having a really down week. But I'm back and I'm feeling good, so that's a good thing. I got a job trial tomorrow. So I'll get the job, it's fine, it's cafe work, I've been doing it for a long time. The only issue with that is I study on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesdays, and they need me to work Monday and Tuesday, so I'm kind of like, well, do I give up my course to work, or do I work and I don't fucking know, do I give up the job? I don't know what I'm going to do. Sorry, I keep getting distracted because my computer keeps turning off my Facebook messages. I've been trying to bulk up a bit, as I probably mentioned before. Doesn't really look that different. Got a bit of a shoulder muscle coming through here. Just a tiny, weeny bit of a bicep. And really thin forearms, unfortunately. Hopefully that'll change. Just still kind of when I pull my bones away, I've got a bit of a muscle coming through here. Looking forward to my neck widening up a bit. That'll be nice. But I like the look of my shoulders. I've got a bit of definition through here. Hopefully that'll just get better and better. Not really that much to update, I'm afraid. I'm just really excited about the appointment next week. I've got STP and a Paker, which arrived not too long ago. I've got them here, they're clean. I use ViraClean, which is mainly for like sex toys and medical play, but you can use them on these too. You just like put a bit of flour on them afterwards. And by the look of it, my dog has chewed on it. What a bitch. I had it sitting next to my computer and it appears. I don't think she's pierced it all the way through though. Sorry, just give me a second. So mine has sliced the teeth mark. This is my STP. You can see where she's been chewing it there. So it's got quite a big opening. I find it amazing. It's called the number one Paker. It was $100 Australian. Really comfortable. You just kind of sit this part, on your bits, on your junk, and this kind of cups just past where you pee. Because there's no like bucket, it's just a slow, there's no way, it's pretty durable, so you don't squeeze it out, doesn't stop the flow in any way. And then because the eye's quite large, again, there's no overflow, no need to be concerned. And it's just got such a good kind of seal, So as long as this part is past where it needs to be, you're pretty much guaranteed to get it in first go. I've used it maybe 20 odd times now with no issue. So yeah, that's a good thing. I'm a bit pissed off that my dog had a chew on it, but now I know to make sure I keep it a little bit higher out of her reach, not just sat on my bedside table. My packer, I'm actually wearing, so I may not pull that out, but it's just standard packer, so I've got a bit of a bulge there. Feels very realistic. I've got the Mr. Floppy, it's a 5 inch. The 3 inch is similar to this, so it's about that long. Just found that it was too small. I wanted something a little bit more substantial in my deck, and you know, the first couple of days I had to get the hang of the positioning and getting used to feeling something there, but good as gold now, loving it sick. The packer was like $40 from Max Black in Newtown, so yeah, that was a bit of a bargain. The packer, the STP was the most expensive thing. What I find with this, it's really good because you can just kind of like sit it in your jocks here, and then when you need it, you don't have to do too much. You just kind of pull it around, push the nose down, and you're good to go. I have an issue with cleanliness, so I've been like rinsing it every single time I use it before I put it back in my pants. Now that means that you need to be really careful in the bathrooms. If there's other people there, you don't want to be seen washing your fucking dick out in the sink. One little sneaky thing that I have been doing is, depending on the cleanliness of the toilet, of course, flush the toilet and then just whip that under the flow just for a second, and then because the water that's coming through the toilet is actually clean water, it does give it a rinse before you pop it back in your pants, because I don't want to be walking around with two stains on my knickers and my jocks. So yeah, that's what I've been doing. What else? I guess that's it really. Keep it short. I'm gonna get my tattoo touched up soon. Pretty shit at the moment. It needs to be made a bit darker after it's faded. Oh well. The lines are straight, so I'm happy. Oh yeah, shaved my head. So I think that I was having a bit of issues with misgendering. The shaved head has seemed to help with that. My face feels like I've been shaving it with like the clippers, just on a number zero. Just so that it gives me that little bit of a prickle rather than it being silky smooth or silky soft. Just like every couple of days, but just want it to feel out. Want it to feel out so bad. Look, that's 8 minutes, nearly 9 minutes of video, so I'll leave it there. Feel free to leave me a message or ask me any questions. You can follow me at butitsendingmeshivers.tumblr.com, or just subscribe to my channel, and I will post another video when I know whether I'm on tea or whatever. What happens after the appointment, I'll let you guys know. Yeah. Alright. Thanks, guys. See you later.